Hello everyone, this is Thomas from Hotkey404, and today we are going to continue our configuration of FreePBX based GSM gateway installed in our case on Raspberry Pi 4. If you have watched our previous video or maybe checked the tutorial from our website, you should already know how to install the system or maybe even how to send an SMS. But there are some questions, namely how to add a dongle trunk, or maybe how to configure inbound and outbound routes so that you can actually make some phone calls. These are some of the questions that we'll answer today. Okay, so let's start by quickly checking our configuration. We will log in to our server, and once we have done that, we can do *-r to log into Asterisk and some V's for increased verbosity. And here, dongle show devices, which will show both dongles that I have connected to my Raspberry, dongle 0 and dongle 1, their state is free. If you need some more details, press dongle show device state and device name. In my case, let's say dongle 0. Here you have some more information, for example, GSM registration status, even location. So, as you can see, there is plenty of information here. Next, we'll exit the console and edit our main dongle configuration file, which is nano, my favorite, /etc/dongle.conf. And here, as you can see, there are dozens of options. We are not going to get into details about all of those, but at the end of this file, you will see our dongle configurations. So we will have dongle 0 and dongle 1. And what is necessary for those devices to work? You have audio and data ports. So those TTY USB devices that are actually responsible for your communication. But I'm not going to explain everything right now. This is material for another video. What is interesting, the first dongle 0 contains extern variable, which is my phone number. As you can see in the second one, it is not that necessary because if you have a default extension, it will direct incoming calls there. And about those names, dongle 0, dongle 1, it is not something necessary. This is actually something that I came up, and this is kind of a standard. You can change it to Huawei or, well, basically whatever. But what you need to remember is the actual name, this context. So dongle 0 and the extension number will be important for our later configuration. So if you have this configuration ready, just remember those two. And now we can exit, go back to our console, and to quickly check if you can actually make phone call with your dongle devices, we'll do channel, originate, and here, channel, which is dongle, our device name, dongle 0, destination number, and here, whatever. Just to check, I'm going to play some music. So after someone receives this phone call, as you can see, it started music on hold. So I will just hang up, and time for our FreePBX configuration. And before I create our dongle trunk, I will quickly create 100 SIP extensions so that I'll be able to test incoming and outgoing connections. And I registered on my soft phone on my desktop. So now time for our main configuration. Now via web browser, we will log into FreePBX administration. And here we have a nice menu. So from that, we will select connectivity. And from the list, we will start with trunks. So we will add a trunk and we will use add custom trunk because, well, that is how the dongle works. As our trunk name, we will use GSM. And since we have two devices, we will identify them by dongle 0. We don't need to set up outbound caller ID because this will be set up by our SIM card's carrier. But since we can place just one outgoing connection with our SIM card, we'll set up one as maximum channel. Then, jumping to third tab, custom settings, we have a nice hint, custom dial string. So we will do that. First, name of our channel, which is dongle. Then, after slash our device name, that is why you needed to remember that, dongle zero. And between dollars, outnum, which is outbound number. It will show a warning that we didn't set up a caller ID, but as we said, with GSM, you don't need that. If we have more than one dongle, we can just repeat this. So once again, GSM, dongle one, one maximum channel, and same dial string with channel, dongle, device name, dongle one in this case, and between dollars, outnum. So that is how you set up trunks to use GSM dongles. Now we will just jump to outbound routes. So we will start with them. Here we will add a new outbound route and our route name, we'll name it GSM out. Well, because it will make it easier to identify the route if you have more of those. And as a trunk sequence, we will start with GSM trunk 0. And in most cases, there will be just one device. If you had more, you can add GSM dongle 1, 2, 3. If you have more devices connected, those USB modems, you will do that. But for simplicity, we will just stay with just one. Here we have dial patterns. And I've noticed that some are setting up just Z, X, and a dot, but I don't feel this is too secure. So to be able to use just local numbers or to dial just local numbers, we'll do Z and 8 axis. More details about dial patterns, maybe in another video. We don't need anything from other tabs, so we'll just submit, and this is what we need to create those outbound routes. And the last setting that we need from connectivity, it is inbound routes. And if you have just one device, you can name it just GSM or GSM in to identify the route. And here we have, I asked you to remember our extension number. So if you have put the extension number in your dongle.conf, you need to place this extension number here. So in my case, I've used my phone number as an extension, so I will place it here. And as a destination, we will set up my one extension that I have set up before the video, as I mentioned. You don't need anything from other tabs, so we can just click submit. And of course, you need to remember that if you have more of those USB modems and you want to have individual destinations, you need to set up more inbound routes. So now let's test our config. So I will just quickly grab my mobile phone and I will call the number from our dongle zero. And what happens on our soft phone and our Asterisk, you can easily see an incoming connection. So this works nicely. And now we will just try outgoing route. So I will call, let's say, my work number, hit dial, and in our Asterisk console, you will see that we are calling with dongle, dongle zero, and our destination phone number. So I will pick up, and as you can see, we have established connection. So I'm not saying that we have covered all the possibilities of dongle configuration, but these are some basics that you need to be able to make those incoming and outgoing connections.
Okay guys, I will be honest with you. My main motivation for this video is the fact that someone asked in the YouTube section how to create dongle trunks in FreePBX. So if you are stuck in your setup, you need some help, some assistance, feel free to let me know in the comment section. Probably we'll be able to figure this out together. So I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you again for watching and see you in the next one.